Hey everyone, I'm Rama, co-founder and CEO of TOCI, and in today's video I want to show you how you can take the outputs of an object detection model such as YOLOv7. So this will be like bounding boxes surrounding text. You want to read the text in the bounding boxes. So yeah, in this example we will use a license plate recognition model that I trained a few weeks ago. I made a video about that. I will leave a link in the description down below so you can watch it before this. So yeah, once you watch that and have a license plate detection model, you can follow on this tutorial to learn how to use that model and perform OCR on them locally in any machine you have with a GPU in near real time. Okay guys, so I want to show you first a little bit the video that I have. It's a video we will use to test the OCR and license plate recognition model. So yeah, you can see there are many cars passing through with license plates, and we will try to detect the license plate and then perform OCR on each detected license plate. All right, so here we are on TOS on the deployment section. You can take a look here. I have the license plate detector model, and this only detects the license plates, but doesn't perform OCR on them. I'm going to drop the video here so you can take a look at how it performs. And then we will do it in the Google Colab notebook that I have here to perform OCR in real time. Okay guys, so here we are in the Google Colab notebook. As you can see, it's very simple, only 6 steps we have to take. The first one is to install all the dependencies, of course. Then we have to install TOS by running the setup, logging in to our account, and setting the project key. Then we will install the algorithm and the weights that we trained in the other video that I told you before about the making the license plate detector. So we will set that to YOLOv7, the YOLOv7 tiny version, and the license plate dataset in the experiment 1 and the best weights in that training. So yeah, then we will have to set a few variables that I will explain a bit later. And this is the script. It's a very simple script that goes around the video, extracting the frames of the video, passing each frame through the object detection model, then it will crop the image in each detection of the license plates and run this crop of the image to the OCR model that will read the text, and then it will draw all the detections and the text the detected to the another video that then will be downloaded to our machine so we can check it out. All right, so let's run the installation first. Alright, the installation finished. You don't have to care about this message, it's okay. So now let's go ahead and run the setup. Now let's log into our account. And now let's go ahead and copy the project key of TOS. I have it here, my project key, and paste it here. All right, so now let's go ahead and set here YOLOv7 because we can take a look here. I have the YOLOv7 tiny version with these weights. So let's go ahead and put YOLOv7 tiny. And let's copy this weight tag and paste it here. Now you can see that TOS downloaded the YOLOv7 code to the notebook and the weights. So let's go here and set these variables. So this is the algorithm. The algorithm, as we said, was YOLOv7. The version tiny and the weights. Then we have here the OCR model parameters. So this is the size of the model. You can see here that we have in the deployment section, if you try the OCR model, we have the small, the medium, and the large. As I showed in the video about the license plate detector, the large model is the best one for real world scenarios like detecting license plates. So that's the one we will use here. So let's go ahead and put large here. Then we have the types of the model. If you select the large version, the large model size, you can change here the model type that are str, print, or handwritten. So yeah, we will use the print one because it's the best one that I tried for this use case. But you can try the other ones if you want. Obviously, the handwritten performs better with handwritten text. But yeah, you can try it out. And then the accuracy, the model accuracy, this is another setting that only can be set if you choose the large model size. So the accuracy is the base, the medium, and the best. Obviously, the better the accuracy, the slower the model will be. So yeah, for this case, we will try the best one because we want to see if it works well with that one. Then you can lower the accuracy if you want it to perform faster, to do faster inference. And then here we have to set the class names that we want to, once the object detection model detected made the detections, the OCR model will check which class that we set here we want to perform OCR on. And we'll crop the image in that part and perform OCR. So here we have the data set that we used. And as you can see, here is the class that is license plate. So I'm going to set it here inside this list. If you have more classes that you want to perform OCR on, you can set it here, like adding a comma and another string. But the only one we care about is the license plate. So yeah, let's run this. And now we have to upload the video here, so we can drop the video that I have here to the Colab notebook, like this. This will take a while if the video is large, but yeah, I recommend not uploading a very large video because it will take a long time. So yeah, probably you will. So yeah, try to upload a short video to try it here and then use it in your own machine if you want to perform in real time. So yeah, while that is uploading, I want to tell you it's a small thing that I'm here using a video from a machine that it's already recorded, but you can change here where we open the video to use your own webcam or any security camera that is connected to the machine. It's very simple to modify this script to use the security camera. So yeah, let me know if you want me to make another video in the comments below about how to do that. But it's also very simple. You can Google how to open a how to open webcam with OpenCV in Python, and you will understand how to do it. It's very simple. Okay guys, so the video finishes uploading to the Colab notebook. Make sure that the name of the video is the same one as the variable input video. You can see that is video.mp4, so make sure it's the same name. So yeah, I'm going to run this, the script. Now it's loading YOLOv7. Now it's loading the OCR model. It will download the model. It's quite large. It weighs 2.5 gigabytes roughly. All right, so now it's detecting the video. Yeah, it's going at 4 frames per second roughly. It may go up a little bit. Now you can see that it went up to nearly 30 frames per second. It goes up and down depending on the number of license plates that it's recognizing at the moment. So if you run this in a much powerful GPU, I'm sure that it will run much faster and in near real time. But it's not that important to do it in real time, like 30 FPS. You can always take a capture of the camera every few seconds and run that. I mean, the car will have to go very, very fast for you to don't capture the license plate. So it doesn't make sense really to perform it at 30 FPS. But yeah, I'm going to leave this here running and then we will check out how it performed. Okay guys, so now we can see that it downloaded the video, the output video to my machine. So let's go ahead and check it out. Alright guys, with that we finish the tutorial. I hope you liked it. So yeah, please leave any comment down below if you have questions. I'm very happy to help you. Also, you can join the Discord community we have. I will leave a link in the description down below where we can personally help you for free and all the community members can help you also to make your computer vision project successful. Alright, so I'm going to leave also the link for the Google Colab notebook and the link for the YouTube video where I trained the license plate detection model that I use in this tutorial. So yeah, please like and subscribe if you like this content and want to see more of it. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.